Jefferson.com and Jefferson Pilot Sports ACC Game of the Week. A huge night in college basketball, the Atlantic Coast Conference included. Boston College's first conference game in this building. Our officials, Gary Maxwell, Jamie Lucky, and Mike Eads. And the tap is controlled to Boston College.
Noel on Smith. That is going to be very interesting.
Oh, yes. Indeed.
Quickness against power.
Dudley off the ball, being checked by Rayshon Terry. There's Jared. He runs the curl. Raises the front iron. Wes Miller coming off a career-high performance on Sunday at Florida State, clearing for North Carolina. 18 points that young man had. First time they had changed the starting lineup in 14 games, and he had a career-high performance.
Oates and Hansbrough. Now, what they're going to try to do is to steal some minutes with Oates. He's not going to handle the ball. Too strong, too quick.
That's an offensive foul. Player control foul off the low blocks as we take a look at our Food Lion starting lineups. As I mentioned, Noel, Terry, Hansbrough, Miller starting just the second time in his career, along with Frazier, Smith, Dudley, Oates, Hennett, and Marshall for Boston College. Of course, we will see a great deal of the freshman Tyrese Rice, whom you were so impressed by when we saw them play North Carolina State a couple of weeks back.
He's explosive, Jim, and he really gets things started, particularly in the offensive end of the floor. Nice decision by Dudley.
Hennett, who is a solid point guard, leads the charge, and there's Smith and that power you talk about. His ability to get shots off in the painted area is incredible.
Well, you can see Hasbro's not going to guard him early in the ball game to try to stay out of foul trouble, but he's awful strong and wide for somebody like Noel to handle inside.
Hansbrough now, who will be checked by many a low post player for Boston College. The jump hook does not go.
Smith, not a big shot blocker. He's a position defender.
Oates rejected but fouled by Rayshon Terry. Billy, let's get a look at your four keys to the game tonight.
Well, these matchups are going to be interesting. We saw that Oates is on Hansbrough early in the ball game, and that is to steal some minutes and to slow him down a little bit. Pressure the point. North Carolina has got to go ahead and get this game played in an up-tempo basis, but Hennett has done a terrific job in regard to assist-turnover ratios, so that's going to be a tough task.
This is a Boston College, as you look at this surprise, and really a tough loss for the Atlantic Coast Conference. North Carolina State, considered to be the second best team in this league behind Duke, blown out by Seton Hall over at the RBC Center tonight.
Well, to put that in perspective, Seton Hall, one of those four teams that have really got to fight for their life just to get in the Big East tournament.
That's right.
Forget about winning any league. And a tremendous blow to the ACC, particularly after that Georgetown-Duke game when it comes Selection Sunday.
Absolutely. We may be talking about more credibility for the Big East looking to get a ninth or tenth team into the NCAAs. And there is talk of that. Hansbrough a little further away from the basket than he would like to be. No give and go, though. Nice defensive work by Oates. Out of bounds off Tyler Hansbrough. It belongs to Boston College.
What we're seeing right now, Hansbrough still down on the floor.
Good reach.
It looked like he hurt his finger or something there.
Yep.
You can see it
fell on top of
it. Yep. Now he's looking to check his eye, see if his contact's still in. Yeah. This is a tough young man
here. I tell you, he's so strong with the basketball, Billy, and it's not as if he keeps the ball high all the time. A lot of times we'll have that ball low to the ground. He still maintains possession.
Well, he rips most things off with two hands. Yeah. You don't find him with any weak rebounds. He's got, in this game already, there are some tough matchups here that the two teams have employed. Illegal screen down inside. And you can see these matchups. I'll tell you, Sean Marshall, with his size, Frazier's on him some. So on one end of the court, Frazier has a big advantage with speed. On the other end, you have Marshall with a big advantage in strength. So look for these matchups in this game. It's really interesting.
John Oates picked up that foul with the illegal screen off the ball, his first. There's Hansbrough again. We talked about that strength in the two hands and making sure that he has strong contact with the leather, which he does every time.
Absolutely, Tim, and you saw that was Jared Dudley that went after that ball, who's very powerful himself and could not knock it out of Hansbrough's hands.
He really locks down on the paint, and positions himself very well, too. Excellent position basketball player to be as young as he is. Miller, that's his spot. It was in Tallahassee, this time a little strong. Hansbrough the follow.
No block out. Now, why would you not block out a man like Hansbrough? Everybody looking for the ball, no block out. He's too good a guy to allow it to be alone.
And again, we talk about position basketball. You don't necessarily think of him as a high riser, but he uses his body beautifully on the low block.
Cheap foul. Hansbrough did not want to commit one that cheap away from the basket against a man who's not going to score. Now watch, there's no block out on him at all. Here he comes, unattended, puts it right back in.
I think it'll be interesting tonight to see, because there are a variety of post players. Oates drawing the assignment for a while, then Smith. Akita McClain is a more athletic player. He'll be in a bit later on for Al Skinner. Dudley comes away empty. It's pulled down by Marshall.
No block out on Marshall.
Smith waiting to read a double team. There it is. Hinnett open for the three.
Good inside-outside action right there. And I thought Hinnett ought to be moving a little bit. They ought to get that ball down to Smith early and often. Put Noel in some real trouble.
Miller on the wing. Excellent find by Hansbrough. 7-5 Boston College.
Well, he just had 6 threes in the last ball game. You would think he wouldn't be unattended out there.
Oh, it's too strong. Rayshon Terry clears. Miller has Hansbrough deep, gives it up to the outstanding young point guard, Bobby Fraser. He's had at least 6 assists every game. Oh, well, too strong. Miller, the long rebound with the dump down to Hansbrough. Over Oates. That's excellent defense. Noel follows. Pulled down by Oates.
You saw that Hansbrough was really trying to get a foul called on that last play. Wasn't called. Boy, Dudley's being very patient right, looking, and they've got it right where they want it right now. Miller better stay in there for the double team. And does.
Yes, he does.
Good move on his part.
And it's that part of his game that drew the attention of Roy Williams. Hansbrough on the other end. Were it not for Wes Miller's on-ball defense, Billy, he wouldn't have had the opportunity to start Sunday night. And a defensive foul called against Miller, trying to check Hinnett. It's a block.
Many times you see a guard drop down to double team inside. Then he gives up and goes back outside. Then it's too late. Good hit ahead.
No doubt about it.
Some of the bigger stars, like Dwayne Wade, they've actually negotiated final cut of their highlights.
I think that works, Dwayne.
You know what? First we should go with a medium to draw the audience in. Then we should go real wide to give it a sense of context.
Dwayne, we're going
to
need that highlight.
When it's ready, then we'll go.
Well, but you missed 2 shows already.
When it's ready. You think we can add a couple more defenders with CGI? That would make me look more like a hero, you know, superhero.
You know your friend Cheese?
Yeah.
That's a nickname, right?
Yeah.
He smell or something?
No.
Does he eat a lot of cheese?
No, actually, he's lactose intolerant.
But what's his first name?
Mike.
What's his last name?
Jankowskiewicz.
It doesn't make any sense.
Okay, one time we were out in the boat, and he pulled out a big old chunk of Limburger, put it on a hook. Apparently, catfish like stinky cheese.
Catfish are so dumb.
We're tied at 7 early on here at the Dean Smith Center. Good to be with Billy Packer. Tim Brando, happy to have you with us. You know, it's interesting. I had a chance to see Roy Williams
this past weekend. He understands with a young team his limitations. Al Skinner coaches with a veteran club knowing their limitations, and that's the quest tonight, to play within themselves.
Well, I think one of the things that Al was probably very disappointed in is starting 0-3 in the conference.
Yes,
but this
yes.
club that was picked preseason number two right behind Duke mm-hmm. certainly has the capabilities with this experience, and as well as they've played in the past years of the Big East, they can be a real contender. This is an important game for them to try to get a breakthrough on the road against one of the other teams that's battling for an upper spot in the ACC.
Oates pops out high. There's Dudley locking up against Danny Green, who just came in after the timeout. Danny Green, number 14, who also played well in a complimentary role the other night. Smith falling away. Tough shot.
Oh,
Marshall, the tip in.
Great tap. No body on him whatsoever.
Sean Marshall with his first deuce.
Sanders coming off his best game. Had four field goals against Florida State. That's exactly how many four field goals he had his entire year as a sophomore.
That's right. You see the early shooting.
And here's his own defense now by Boston College coming out of that situation. Good recognition.
Miller over Marshall. Raises the iron. Dudley with the long rebound.
Nice job by Frazier, realizing his backcourt teammate had taken the shot, and Marshall had broken for a long pass. Frazier got back there with him.
Made sure the floor was balanced.
Absolutely. Good job.
Smith being checked by Noel. That's the matchup that you find so compelling.
Boston College, you've got to attack that matchup early in the game. Noel, a very important, experienced player for North Carolina. You could get him in some foul trouble early.
Now, Roy Williams unhappy with that foul picked up by Miller. It's his second, and it will force him to the bench. Marcus Ginyard comes in for him, the freshman from Alexandria, Virginia. And Ginyard had been pressing somewhat, and that was one of the reasons, along with Miller's defense, that Roy Williams decided to shake up the starting lineup. Akita McLean has also come in for Boston College. You see North Carolina, three more team fouls committed during the first five-plus minutes here at the Dean Dome. Marshall off the curl. Smith.
And no block out. Tough miss.
He did everything but flush it.
He didn't miss many of those, but he had got to block out that big body.
And McLean using his body. Now, that's an example of the changing defenses because of the different body types that Al Skinner can throw at Tyler Hansbrough.
Well, McCain picked up one of those cheap off the ball. He's pushing with his body. Referee right behind him gets a perfect view, as you can see there. No question about the foul.
Frazier triggers it into Sander.
Zone out of bounds situation.
Now you see they're fronting Hansbrough.
Matching up with a little bit. That was a pretty good pass. Should have been caught.
Hansbrough is going to have to adjust each time Skinner makes a change with his defense of Tyler Hansbrough. Dudley up top.
I like the doubling down that North Carolina is doing on Smith, preventing him from getting off to a huge game early.
Terry lost his balance as he was going through. Actually, Marcus Ginyard, I beg your pardon. And a foul spotted against Hennett.
With Miller out, Ginyard in, that gives North Carolina obviously a lot more size. So right now, North Carolina's got one of the tallest teams they can put on the floor.
Now Quentin Thomas will come in. This will make him a little taller. He checks in for Frazier.
You've got Sanders out there, Hansbrough out there, Terry out there, Ginyard.
And another defender for Tyler Hansbrough coming in, Sean Williams, who only became eligible prior to our game against North Carolina State that opened Boston College's home ACC season a few weeks back.
As a freshman, broke the all-time block record for Boston College, so he's on Hansbrough now, and he'll be looking to try to snuff some shots. Two good penetration moves by Ginyard so far in the game. Got fouled on the first one.
What a nice rebound by McLean. Williams late with that pass, picked off by Terry. Three turnovers now for the Eagles. Sanders.
Nice.
Oh, his confidence has really picked up.
What I like so much about that, a big man who caught the ball moving at full speed and made the play. Terrific job on his part.
Billy, this is a kid that only played about 3 minutes a game a year ago. Roy Williams came to Byron Sanders before the season started and said, look, we need more from you. I'm going to count on you for 14 to 15 minutes. And He responded in Tallahassee in a manner that he had not throughout his career. And a nice silencer coming from Lewis in it. Boston College by two.
And the crowd really was into it.
It's a veteran BC team. They love to play from ahead. They're not necessarily that effective when down double digits. There's the blow by Ginyard, and a foul as he gets it to the low block.
Timmy, the young man has touched the ball three times, has made three good penetration dribble moves.
Lewis Hennett picked up that foul. Sanders running the floor like a big game James, huh? We'll be back.
Fundamentals. Watch right here. He got sloppy. Here, right here. That's where he loses it. Let's look at that again.
Hey, honey, did you
always switch it to the other hand, away from where the pursuit is coming?
What exactly are you doing?
That's a mental breakdown. He got a little reckless there, and I'm sure he's going to catch an earful on the sidelines.
Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
天气预报：今天和星期三将会持续低湿度和晴朗。
只要消费
者。Houston, need them one day closer to you.
Houston, need them next to you.
Well, honey.Houston.
11-9, Boston College by two. I missed mentioned James Worthy a little earlier. These numbers for Tyler Hansbrough would remind some of Sam Perkins, particularly when you look at his freshman field goal shooting percentage, Billy. Pretty impressive stuff.
Really great when you take into consideration he's leading his team in scoring and in rebounding. That's never been done by a freshman in the history of North Carolina basketball. Young man, six times rookie of the week. A lot of season yet to go. The all-timer was Kenny Anderson down there at Georgia Tech. He had 10, and that's not beyond the realm of possibility for this young guy. He's tied with Sam Perkins, the all-time leader at North Carolina, with six rookie of the week awards. Passing the likes of, you know, like a Ralph Sampson won five times. You start talking about being in that company. Heady. Talking about three-time national player of the year, was only rookie of the year in the ACC five times.
We'll take a look at halftime at a number of impressive freshmen at North Carolina through the years. Boston College by one. Just over 11 and a half minutes remaining here in the first half. Tyrese Rice, we mentioned him a few moments ago. He can change the speed of the game and the matchup, certainly. He's come back into the point. A new takeaway by Marcus Ginyard.
And nice move by Ginyard to stick it out there with his right hand. So still protecting himself from any kind of backdoor cut.
Craig Smith checks in, replacing Akita McLean for Boston College.
Smith and Dudley. Dudley's number two in the league in regard to minutes played. He hasn't been out yet. Smith's just a very short break. And he's right there at 34 minutes a game. It's a lot of minutes for a guy as active as he is. Good pass.
Oh, a nice pass. First from Smith out of the double team, and then Williams the finish.
Now, we talk about double team and Smith. I'm talking about when he's in the paint, not when he's 35 feet from the basket. Mistake by North Carolina. But they are matching up out of this zone.
Really some pretty good defense played by both teams early on.
A lot of size and a lot of bulk on this Boston College team on the floor right now.
Terry on the wing.
Rayshon Terry, you saw him light up Kentucky. He had 25. He had 17 points and 8 boards in Tallahassee. When he plays well, Billy, particularly early, North Carolina is a much tougher out.
I'll say something about him last year. Didn't get a chance to play much, as we know. But he was 12 for 20 from 3, which is 60%. So showed even then with little playing time that he could put him up.
Terry all over the place trying to pick up a steal from Williams. Red Smith a bit further away from the basket, gives it up to Dudley. Shot clock under 10. Rice feeds Marshall on the wing. Oh, pretty good athletic move by Williams. He did not have the position. He's the last to touch it. North Carolina has it. Well, Alltel Text to Win ACC Trivia Challenge. Alltel presents Text to Win. Today's question is, BC played one ACC team in their first NCAA tournament appearance in 58. Would it be A, B, or C? Well, use your Alltel wireless phone to text your answer to short code ACCFAN. That's 222-326, or visit theacc.com to submit your answer. We'll have it for you a bit later on.
A little piece of trivia about that game. It was the first time BC ever played in a television game.
How about that? You would know. You would know that piece of
well, that
history.
Means I should know who played.
Yes,
right?
Indeed. Green. Danny Green, down 13 with a minute left, hit two big shots to carve into that Florida State lead. Got it down to 8 and made it much more manageable on Sunday night. Rice falling
away.
He's something, isn't he?
Plus got the body on him, which kicked him back to the outside. Green gets another wide open.
Why not? That's fertile ground, that Green, playing here in Blue Heaven.
And that was Rice's fault. He made the shot and then looked upon himself for a little favor and didn't get back down on defense, and it cost him. It's a tough matchup for Ginyard. Rice is really quick with that ball.
Dudley, that ball was deflected. Comes back out to Hinnett. Now they're doing a lot of this, Al Skinner, using both Hinnett and Rice on the floor simultaneously. Too strong from Rice.
Look at Hansbrough handle that ball and hustle.
Oh! What a move by Hansbrough! Count it and a foul.
Now you want to talk about some talent. Here's a guy gets a long rebound, leads the fast break with the dribble, gives it up at the right time, finishes against the leading shot blocker in BC's history, and still puts it away with a great two-handed dunk. That is some basketball play.
And again, we talk about how you can be strong in possessing the ball, and that situation required a lot of finesse in midair, and he made it happen.
That was his 130th free throw. And you talk about a freshman shooting more free throws than anybody in the league. That's really saying something about his aggressiveness.
And there comes that pressure on Rice on the perimeter. Leads to a foul. This is now a 12-2 North Carolina run. And their lead is 7, 22-15.
And all done by freshman Green with those outside shots, and Hansbrough with a sensational play, length of the floor. Again, I think if you're BC, you got to spread things out a little bit and get Smith down in the low blocks. They've gotten away from it for about the last 5 minutes, and it's taken away from their game.
Maryland a winner tonight at Georgia Tech, a very big win for them.
There he is. And a double team down. By not touching it for a while, he becomes impatient with a shot.
Boston College has got to stay close. This is not a team that plays well from behind double digits.
And a little kind iron for Hansbrough now. He's got 9. And the lead is 9.
And would you say 7 times ACC hook it?
BC needs a bucket. I know it's early, but they really need one, and Hinnett does it again. That's twice he's silenced the crowd.
That's a tray, 24-18. Well, they get behind by double digits. This is not a deep team. That's their Achilles heel. They can only go 8 deep.
Start.
After a 3-for-10 start, they hit their last 6 field goals, North Carolina.
Well, I think that's why Al Skinner went to this bench early. He doesn't want to turn it into some kind of a running marathon here for his club.
Noel picked up the foul with a screen. 7:41 remaining, and the Tar Heels lead by 6.
in sports, if you want to know where you're going,
LeBron,
you've got to know where you've been.
Jordan, look at that!
On Classic Now, we tie the past to the present.
From Unitas to Marino to Manning, Wilt to Kareem to Shaq, Koufax to Clemens to, well, Clemens. Every weeknight, host Josh Elliott brings you the sports news like you've never seen it before. Classic Now, where the past is always present. Weeknights at 7 and 11, only on ESPN Classic.
If you don't have ESPN Classic, get Classic Now.
Scott?
Mm-hmm.
Did you possibly switch chairs with me?
No, not me.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Good luck finding your chair, LeBron.
Okay. Okay.
Own the best DVDs from ESPN Home Entertainment.
I'm all in.
The compelling dramas.
Bannister, you'll never forgive yourself if someone else gets there first.
The hard-hitting stories.
The Olympics will go on.
The memorable games. From fans.
Let's rock and roll.
For fans.
You got to know the fundamentals.
Ain't nobody better than me.
Own these amazing DVDs. Available in stores and at ESPNShop.com. From ESPN Home Entertainment.
Billy, at the beginning you said one of the keys would be handling Hansbrough. Right now their hands are full.
Well, they really are. The young man has done a terrific job. There you see no block out where he put one back up early in the ball game. Down inside, posts up well, right over the top with a great half hook. And the play of the game so far is one that we didn't show there, is where he got the long rebound, took it about 60 feet, gave it up, and got it back for a dunk. Terrific play.
Tim Brando, Billy Packer, happy to have you with us here at the Dean Smith Center. North Carolina by six. In the midst of a 12-2 run, they got an 8-point lead. And a bit of an answer by Boston College. Kennett now looking for some help down low. Williams pops out high. Nice look. Nice look by Tyrese Rice, feeding Marshall.
Marshall has got a good back cut off of Smith. He's got that wide body, tough to get around him when he sets that screen.
Boston College doesn't use the three like a North Carolina State, but they do at times backdoor you like an NC State. Dig into that 35-second shot clock each possession.
Sanders from Thomas.
That's the second outstanding catch by Sanders in this game. The first one on the run, fast break for a layup, and that one a tough catch in traffic. Real good improvement in that phase of his game. There you see a lot of screening down and low. Almost eight players inside the paint when Boston College employs that back screen.
Marshall pops out on the wing again over Terry. And he rattles that one home. Rayshon Terry
a little late in getting over.
26-23. There's a steal by Rice.
Hard to catch that young man. He's quick.
Clinton Thomas has had a real turnover problem for Roy Williams. One of the reasons he surrendered his position early on as the heir apparent at the point.
And I'll tell you, particularly against Rice, it'd be smart to keep that ball out of Thomas's hands.
Hey fans, RBC Centura, official corporate partner of the ACC, wants you to be a VIP at the ACC tournament. You and the guests can watch the ACC tournament in style from the convenience of the luxury suite. To find out how, just log on to rbccentura.com for details. RBC Centura, official bank of the ACC. Sean Williams picking up his second foul. And Wes Miller at the free throw line.
Considering what Smith has done in the last three games, averaging almost 22 points and 15 rebounds a game, North Carolina doing a pretty good job keeping the ball out of his hands.
Oh, they couldn't sleep there.
That's one of the few times the floor is not balanced, and Williams beat him down the floor.
Thomas rejected. Noel has it slapped away. Terry initiated that contact. Wave it off. Good call. Craig Smith is really tricky that way.
Yep. That's the second charge he has drawn in this ball game. He uses that wide body. He is not a shot blocker. He's a position defender. Now watch him right here. Gets position, does not try to go up and block the shot, and uses that strong body. As soon as he feels the contact, he goes down. Very good defensive play in his part.
Billy, I was talking to Al Skinner today about the development of and the evolution of his team and some of his individual players into this league, and he said, I believe the officials and maybe even some of the players on opposite teams are beginning to understand just how good Craig Smith is.
Well, I hope they're not. I hope they're refereeing the game regardless of who he is, what jersey he's wearing, and just call the game the way that it's played and how they see it. They shouldn't be picking out individual players, whether they be good or bad.
Marshall double-teamed on the low block. As it's stripped by Frazier, stays with it, though.
Boy, that was pretty tough.
Marshall's doing a terrific job here. A veteran ball player, extremely strong. And there you see this matchup, 2-3.
He has 11 points, does Marshall, Billy. There's Green trying to do it on his own. And he gets some contact from Rice on the blow-by. Tyrese Rice picks up the foul. Well, let's take a trip around the ACC, brought to you by Chevrolet. Duke and Virginia Tech, a rematch of the December shot by Sean Dockery. Virginia Tech's fallen on difficult times since then.
Well, remember what Virginia Tech did to him last year.
That's right. And, of course, Saturday you'll be back here for that matchup between Arizona and North Carolina. The league, frankly, could use a very important out-of-conference victory. And they get a chance against an Arizona team that's been up and down.
Well, the same could be said about the Pac-10.
Yes, that's true.
West Virginia going out to UCLA last week, where the Big East continues to roll. Arizona not having the kind of season that we're accustomed to seeing from a Lute Olson squad.
Look at that. 6-for-6 field goals for Boston College. A little bit like that return to sender run that North Carolina had.
North Carolina in their point zone now, 1-3-1. So we see a man-to-man. Little zone for North Carolina, man-to-man, and a matchup zone by Boston College so far in this first half.
This run by Boston College is very important to regather some control of the game's tempo. Ah, John Madden right on top of it.
Now there's a stats man that knows how to handle an entry pass.
He's protecting his play-by-play guy. I like that. Don't forget, our next broadcast comes to you Saturday, Virginia Tech, the same Hokies we were mentioning earlier, against Wake Forest, and the Demon Deacons are in need of a win. Rice, a jump stop and a deuce.
Boy, I tell you, Boston College did a great thing there. Rice, with just 8 seconds to go, had the ball in his hands, the perfect man to take somebody one-on-one off the dribble.
Green with Miller, Frazier, Noel, and Hansbrough on the floor for North Carolina. There's the high lob. He's really dynamite in there. Missed a chippy, though. McClain comes down with a rebound. You'll rarely see Tyler Hansbrough miss that.
Rice got a little greedy. Noel took it away, but it's saved to McClain of Boston College. Marshall. Oh! And that's going to be a push. Spotted against North Carolina. They're going to whistle Danny Green for them. His first. 3:50 remaining in the half.
ABC News Now. Finally, something designed for your hectic life. Imagine programs 15 minutes long and tightly packed with all the good stuff you actually want. Hit the ground running with ABC News Now.
ABC News Now.
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 ABC News Now.
Get it?
Now.
Now.
ABC News.
Anytime, anywhere.
Get it? Now.
Now imagine being able to get it all. Anytime and anywhere. Hey, that's why you need ABC News Now.
Thanks for filling in, Mr. Urlacher.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Happy to help.
Join us in March for ESPN The Weekend at the Walt Disney World Resort. There's something for every fan. Visit ESPNTheWeekend.com today. Presented by SpeedStick 24/7.
You all right?
Yeah.
professional football injury. Tore my rotator cuff against the Giants in 88. Yeah, gotta play hurt though, right?
Oh, absolutely. Actually, I burnt my tongue on some lentil soup last night. It really hurts.
Be okay to do the show?
Oh yeah, I'll suck it up.
What makes them different makes them great. Mike and Mike in the Morning on ESPN Radio.
Well, this thing is just about over now. They'll snap the ball, take a knee, and that'll end it. The Bills are going to drop this one, and wait a second. The ball is loose. Fisher's got it, and he's got Walker to the 20. He's to the 10. Touchdown, Bills! Listen to this place! Holy moly! What? No! They're going to say he stepped out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The game comes to an end. The Bills lose a heartbreaker.
To 28, Boston College leading it by three.
Tim, one thing jumps out at you. Amazing right here in the fact that we have Boston College with 31 points, and you have Smith and Dudley with a total of two. Now, if you said before this game started to me that we're looking at 350 to go in the first half, Smith and Dudley have two, I'd say, boy, North Carolina's in a big lead.
Yeah.
So that just goes to show you good balance here. And the two stars have been extremely patient on the offensive end of the floor.
They really have. And Sean Marshall's played so big. He has 11 points on 5 of 8 shooting. And a similar start by a guy like Craig Smith, for instance, a couple of weeks back at home against NC State. And you saw frustration creep into his game. I don't see any of that.
No, I don't. I see him working. I see him thinking out there. Now they're back to straight man-to-man. It turns out that Miller's with Smith. They ought to find that out, get Miller outside here with the ball. Frazier goes in the opposite direction.
We need a little stop and go and a pull up.
Soft touch, huh?
The iron unkind, but tantalizingly, it almost dropped through for Green, who has been getting a lot of shooters' rolls lately.
There's with a little more experience, Frazier would realize it was a mismatch. Miller on Smith, and he went to the opposite side. You've got to see that as a point guard. You know where you can make something work.
Smith gets Hansbrough away from the bucket and then feeds Dudley.
Second time today. Not a big back screen right there for Dudley, but he used his movement really well without the ball.
People forget about the passing ability of Craig Smith. He does have outstanding vision when he goes to the high post.
You notice how he sits down too an awful lot when he passes, so he gets that ball low to the floor. Tough to stop defensively.
That ball was deflected by Smith. A turnover for North Carolina, their seventh.
Nice solid play in this sequence here by Boston College, led by Marshall.
Oh, and a foul on Smith off the ball, working against Hansbrough.
And this freshman getting some calls, isn't he?
There's nothing like college basketball, and if you're celebrating the win, do it right. The way you celebrate says a lot about you and reflects on your school. So be responsible. Take care of yourself and your friends. A message from Anheuser-Busch.
Smith and Skinner probably trying to say, hey, you know, the senior who's been all-conference 3 years in a row in the Big East is the guy that's supposed to get the calls, not the rookie.
Yeah. Well, UConn, number one, and knocking off St. John's tonight, who's been playing so well of late.
Hilliard again looking to put that ball on the floor and penetrate. He did a good job. That's way downtown.
Smith gets the rebound right over Sanders. Rice operating at the point, along with Smith, the feet of the plane. Hilliard dogging him, almost comes away with a pick. Rice right to the rack.
That young man is explosive, and he's exciting.
Green on the run out. Ooh,
is he okay?
May have hurt himself there.
Oh, that is the kind of injury that you can get when that leg gets down there. He's sitting on the floor.
It looked like it could be a hyperextension of some kind, but apparently he's all right. That was dangerous to watch.
It really was. He's staying out there and running it off, but it's hurting him a little bit.
Yeah, as if he slipped, he extended himself. This is the largest lead of the night for Boston College, and it comes towards the last 90 seconds of the first half.
As Green did not realize that the team was in his zone, he got caught out of position, almost hurt him.
Well, quick hands of Smith, the rebound, finds Dudley. Those two guys can work the high-low game very well.
Oh, they can, and Dudley is so strong.
BC's lead is 9. Their most impressive
road performance, of course, coming at Miami, and now an opportunity against BC. This Miami team, of course, came in and beat North Carolina at home. And a foul against Marshall.
Now, with this kind of a lead, not a bad move to try to make that big play there. Normally, you want to be a little bit more solid, but they've got a working margin here.
Take a look at the top 25 teams in the nation presented by Q Motor Oil. We talked about how important it is for the ACC to continue to keep some teams in the top 25. But they've taken a few lumps now in some non-conference play, including tonight across town at the RBC Center, NC State losing to Seton Hall.
Well, it not only hurts NC State, but as we said at the top when that score came through, it really hurts the Atlantic Coast Conference, and is a great move for the Big East, which already has made a name for itself and just keeps improving there.
Boston College has outscored North Carolina, Billy, 22-6 in the last 6 minutes of this half.
And North Carolina's back in the zone, this time at 2-1-2. Hansborough in the middle.
Rice, a rainbow Jay.
Has he exploded for this team? He can really put points on the board in a hurry.
Tyrese has 11, matching that of Sean Marshall, who's led the way for the Eagles. We've seen their complementary players step into the box score, while guys like Smith and Dudley have played a different role.
And a timeout. We should get a timeout here. Doesn't get it.
Dudley feeds Rice. Back to Dudley.
And a three-point opportunity. Terrific decision by Rice. And we talked about how strong Dudley is.
That's not an easy pass to make in that kind of traffic.
And he is quick, though. He doesn't worry about anything. He's got the ball in his hands. He dribbles low to the floor, and he can make plays.
Hinyard got the foul, his second. ACC basketball is brought to you in part by your local Toyota dealers.
What a finish to this first half for the Road Eagles.
Second foul, Dudley's missed.
North Carolina to hold for one. This is an incredible run to close out the half.
Frazier on his own. Frazier recovers it for Ginyard. Too strong. And we come to intermission.
Boston College with a 26-6 run to close the first half. And the preseason All-America, Craig Smith, has to feel pretty good. Though his numbers are down, his team has a double-digit lead here at halftime at the Dean Smith Center in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Halftime activities coming up.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Chick-fil-A, by BB&T, by Chevrolet, by Quaker State, and by Progress Energy.
Your golf game to the next level? Learn from the professionals at ESPN Golf Schools presented by Lexus. Enroll in the 3-Club Tour and receive a Nike Sasquatch driver, SV wedge, and T100 putter free. ESPN Golf Schools instruction developed by world-renowned teaching pro Hank Haney. Call 1-800-642-5528 or register online at ESPNGolfSchools.com. Improve your game through personalized instruction and the latest in equipment from Nike Golf. ESPN Golf Schools, presented by Lexus.
Guys, if you're not nervous, you're not alive. Get an opportunity like this, you gotta be. I'm gonna leave it all right here.
They're not getting screened. Don't get screened.
Go, Benny, go. What are you doing here?
It ought to hurt to get an opportunity like that, and we didn't get it done.
We'll be right back. Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
Burglary, assault, homicide,
killing of unborn child.
Friday on an all-new Injustice.
I believe I helped put away an innocent man.
There's only one team that can right something so wrong.
You can free an innocent man.
What made you change your mind?
You fight for what you believe in.
Your ex-wife's ID'd the wrong man.
That's what's going to nail you.
An all-new Injustice, Friday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
.42-30 Boston College with the lead here at halftime. Our ACC game of the week. Tim Brando back again with Billy Packer. And Billy, we talked about Tyler Hansbrough. He had 9 points in the first 12 minutes. Really was the key, I thought, to North Carolina getting out to a quality start. Did not score the last eight, and Boston College went on an incredible run.
I thought the veteran leadership of Boston College, with Smith being extremely patient tonight in the ballgame, opened things up. When North Carolina tried to pack at him, the ball went outside and everybody delivered, particularly Rice.
You talk about these young players, though, like a Tyler Hansbrough. Through the years at North Carolina, you've seen them all. I mean, and it really did begin with Phil Ford, didn't it? I mean, it really.
Well, he was the first freshman ever to start for the great Dean Smith. And, of course, he was a great player. Was the ACC player of the year that year in the ACC tournament. Not bad for a freshman. O'Corrin, James Worthy, Sam Perkins.
Of course, Michael Jordan. And
number 23, who didn't end up his freshman year too poorly with that jump shot from the corner.
J.R. Reed and Antoine Jamison bringing us into the more contemporary Carolina freshman era. Easy Ed Cota could make plays. And without question, Joseph Forte was smooth as silk from beyond the arc and within. When you think about it, just at the core of that talent, that's the essence, really, of the tradition of this school.
And you got to remember, most of those guys ended up playing 4 years, so a lot different than it is now. So that they had multiple guys that we saw on there on the same team. So you can imagine the great wealth of talent that Dean Smith was able to assemble, utilize, and coach extremely well.
There's some of that tradition high in the rafters of the Dean Smith Center. So many great ones. And the reigning champions find themselves down by a dozen to a veteran team from Boston.
Burglary, assault, homicide,
killing of unborn child.
Friday on an all-new Injustice.
I believe I helped put away an innocent man.
There's only one team that can right something so wrong.
You can free an innocent man.
What made you change your mind?
You fight for what you believe in.
Your ex-wife ID'd the wrong man.
That's what's going to nail you.
An all-new Injustice, Friday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC. Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
Well, this thing is just about over now. They'll snap the ball, take a knee, and that'll end it. Bills are going to drop this one, and wait a second. The ball is loose. Fisher's got it, and he's got Walker to the 20. He's to the 10. Touchdown, Bills! Listen to this place! Holy moly! What? No! They're going to say he stepped out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The game comes to an end.
Boston College leads by 12 here at the Dean Smith Center on our ACC Game of the Week. Let's take a look at our Bud Light scoreboard. Oh, some shockers tonight. NC State loses by 18 to Seton Hall at the RBC Center across town. Maryland, without McCray, ineligible academically, goes on the road to beat Georgia Tech.
Then over in the SEC, how about South Carolina up on Florida by 14? That game in Columbia. Bruce Pearl, a breath of fresh air in the SEC, up big. LSU rolling over Georgia. They may be the most talented five-loss team in America and should be ranked soon. Ole Miss, Rob's squad, losing their first game the other night down early. Connecticut over St. John's. They'll remain number one with a bullet. Illinois up on Minnesota in the first half. West Virginia trailing Marshall in an intrastate battle. Michigan State going down to Michigan in another one. GW, they are a team to watch come tournament time, winning over Duquesne. And then look at Wisconsin after losing at home to North Dakota State, blowing out Penn State, and Oklahoma up on Baylor. Let's take a look now at the ACC standings presented by Toyota. Interestingly, for North Carolina State, a team that had separated itself in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Many thought that they were the prohibitive number two to Duke, and yet they lose tonight at home. In conference play, Virginia has been the Cinderella story. Dave Leto's club just finding a way. Maryland's got to feel good about the road win tonight. We've updated these, of course, based on what's already happened. North Carolina would love to join Maryland and Virginia, but they're going to have to come back to do it. Number of teams in the middle beginning to get crowded, which we anticipate before the ACC tournament in Greensboro. Billy and I will be back with more halftime activities right after this.
My name is Izzy Paskowitz, and I've been running surf camps for autistic kids for 7 years. What's perfect for us is to see that screaming and the kicking when they go out, and when they turn around and ride that wave in, it's just nothing like it. And there's the parents, tears in their eyes, saying, we've had a lot of tough times, but today was just a perfect day.
Say, Rain, you know ESPN Classic has a new comedy block, weeknights at 10.
What kind of shows
they got? Funny shows.
Good shows.
Great shows.
Who's on first?
Cheapsy.
Who?
Cheapsy.
The show.
Cheapsy.
On first.
Cheapsy.
What's on second?
Harless.
What?
Harless.
That's what I'm asking.
That's
you.
That's what I'm telling.
Right, let me see if I got this straight. ESPN Classic has a new block, comedy, weeknights at 10.
Yes.
Who's on first? What's on second?
No, Cheapsy's is on first. Harless is on
That's
second.
What I said. Who's on first? What's on second?
No, you're replacing the words Cheapsy's with who and Harless with what. So?
Why?
I don't know.
Third base!
The comedy block, weeknights at 10, only on ESPN Classic.
Stop it.
I'm in.
You love the NFL. You live for the NFL. To you, the NFL is life itself. And ESPN News is your never-ending source for NFL news, highlights, scores, and stats. With shows like The Blitz and Monday Quarterback.
Successful quarterbacks watch coverage. They do not watch their receivers.
Live press conferences, deep analysis.
They play football the way it's supposed to be played.
All things NFL 24/7. Find it at ESPN News.
Over NC State on January 15th, Sylvia Hatchell recorded the 700th victory in her 31-year coaching career. Hatchell becomes the fifth Division I women's coach to reach the 700-win plateau. It is her 428th victory in her 20-year career at the helm of the Tar Heel program, which also includes a national championship. Congratulations to Sylvia Hatchell of North Carolina for marking her moment in ACC history. Presented by GEICO.
42-30, Boston College leads by 12 here at halftime. Tim Brando alongside Billy Packer. Billy talked about it early on, the matchups in this game, how important they would be. Tyler Hansbrough had it early on, and then Boston College, with its changing defenses, got to him.
Well, I think that basically what you saw right here is the patience of the veteran team, Boston College, waiting until they had good openings inside. You see right there, excellent back screens. And there you see Smith, who's been patient all night, has only scored 2 points in this ball game. But because he's been patient, he's opened it up for his teammates.
A look at our halftime stats presented by Sonic Drive-Ins. Now, think about this. BC hit 12 of their last 14 field goals, a scintillating 58% for the first half.
58%. Another thing that really jumps out at me, and I didn't realize this until looked at stats going into this game, BC's number one in the ACC in the assist-turnover ratio. Yeah. In this first half, 11 assists, only 4 turnovers. Terrific job on their part handling the ball and getting the ball where it needs to be at the right time.
North Carolina coming off such a big road win, would love to keep the momentum. They're going to have to come from behind to do it again.
Some of the bigger stars, like Dwayne Wade, they've actually negotiated final cut of their highlights.
I think that works, Dwayne.
You know what? First we should go with a medium to draw the audience in. Then we should go real wide to give it a sense of
Dwayne,
context.
We're going to need that highlight.
When it's ready, then we'll go.
Well, but you missed 2 shows already.
When it's ready. You think we can add a couple more defenders with CGI? That would make me look more like a hero, you know, superhero.
You know your friend Cheese?
Yeah.
That's a nickname, right?
Yeah.
He smell or something?
No.
Does he eat a lot of cheese?
No, actually, he's lactose intolerant.
What's his first name?
Mike.
What's his last name?
Jankowskiewicz.
It doesn't make any sense.
Okay, one time we were out in the boat, and he pulled out a big old chunk of Limburger, put it on a hook. Apparently, catfish like stinky cheese.
Catfish are so dumb.
ACC basketball is brought to you by Red Lobster, by your Carolina Jeep dealers, by Aquafina, by Hyundai, and by RBC Centura.
The beautiful campus on Chapel Hill. Boston College leading it by 12 against the Tar Heels as we get ready for second half action. Marshall and Rice, Tyrese Rice, whom you were so high on a couple of weeks ago, and you can see how he ignited the team when he came on the floor. Again, complimentary players, Hansbrough and Green. He remains warm from his performance the other night in Tallahassee.
Had one of those freshman breakdowns when he got double teamed, though, over on this side. Got to understand, when the team's making a run on you, the possession of the ball is extremely important. If you called the timeout, you wouldn't have given up that fast break opportunity, and maybe his team could have scored. Nice hands.
Hansbrough comes away with it. Leans in, gets the foul, and will get to the line. Count it. Could be an old-fashioned three-point play to open the second half.
We talked about his strength. We talked about him running the court. Well, here, he shows you he's got some good brains, because no guy gets to the foul line that doesn't know how to draw fouls. And for just being a freshman, Hansbrough is about as good as anybody I've seen come into the league in a long time.
23rd three-point opportunity converted. And by the way, how about this? 55 of his last 56 free throws hit coming into tonight's game. When you're going to get to the line as much as he does as a big man, boy, what an advantage that is.
Yeah, he's shooting 75% on the year, but early on he wasn't shooting as well.
Dudley had that one rejected.
Yeah, I think Terry got a little piece of that one.
Good deflection by Lewis Hennett. Yep. Was ready to spot up on the wing had he received that pass.
You know, North Carolina was having a pretty nice run. Remember, the crowd was really into it, and Hennett right down in that very spot hit that jump shot and said he quieted the crowd. And when you think back to him, that really was the changing point in that first half. The Boston College went on a terrific run. There they are again, matching up in this zone. I think North Carolina ought to play against this zone as if it's a man-to-man and just run their man-to-man stuff.
Hands roll. Doubled quickly. Noel on the wing. Well, that'll get him out of the zone if Noel, along with Terry and Miller, can begin to knock down trays.
And what made that play again is the tremendous strength of Hansbrough's hands is able to fight off that double team.
North Carolina with six unanswered in the first minute. Good pass, Marshall. He missed a chippy. In traffic, the putback won't go. Long rebound to Noel. And it again, denying those passes on the wing.
If Frazier had been a little bit more wide open, Noel had cut from the opposite side. There's that good kick out, and we talked about Ansbro's hands and the strength. If Frazier had waited, he'd had Noel for an easy layup.
How about that upset, South Carolina, and another one. Marshall.
Is that an upset, Tim, or had Florida played such a weak schedule?
Maybe. I mean, their most impressive win was Syracuse in New York back in November.
Well, prior to losing their first game at Tennessee, they had played against a team that was ranked 334 out of 334 in the RPI. That's not what you can do when you're the team ranked number two in the country.
They were only had one win against the top 50 in the RPI. But you raise an excellent point. Now, upset is used far too often in our college basketball vernacular.
Illegal screen.
Yep. Oates again gets caught with it. That's number three on John Oates.
But Oates' job is just to stay out of that floor for about 15 to 18 minutes a game, draw some fouls, and occupy some minutes to keep Smith out of foul trouble early on.
Akita McClain will replace him, which means the defense of Hansbrough is likely to change. You see the turnover story. North Carolina had a penchant for it early. They tried to go with the backdoor lob.
Not a good play at all. Six down, playing well in the second half. Don't try to go for a home run.
Hennett does. Back door right to Akita McClain. Pass got away from Terry. A little too strong from Noel. Could not corral it.
Well, you know, I really don't fault Terry on the bad catch. The ball should never have been thrown. Two big mistakes, mental mistakes for North Carolina. North Carolina back into their zone set. 1-3-1 point zone.
Clain trying to set a high pick. North Carolina fights through it pretty well.
Look for Hennett and Marshall, who are the two guys who are the most likely to put it up from outside.
Hennett with the dump down. Good entry to Smith, who gets that up so quickly over Hansbrough.
Well, Hansbrough never should have been behind him in that zone defense. Three passes in a row by North Carolina, but errant passes.
Tie ball with the arrow to Boston College. Boston College answers that 6-0 run.
I mentioned that Boston College, number one in the conference in regard to assist turnover ratio. North Carolina is number six, and it's really hurt him here in the start of the second half.
The turnover story, and I talked to Roy Williams this weekend about it. Their past losses on the road, particularly the loss at Southern California, was a bit of a blueprint. Florida State tried to turn them over with pressure. Boston College, not the kind of team, Billy, that's going to pressure you full court. But North Carolina's turned it over in the front court a great deal tonight, especially in this half. Miller, secondary break, Noel to Hansbrough.
textbook North Carolina secondary break.
The second time tonight Ensborough scored on the break by running the floor well. Back to man-to-man is North Carolina.
And a push by Quentin Thomas against Marshall.
You know, when you think there's that good pass inside, Hansborough with the good hands. Think back to 94 when these two teams played. Dean Smith, 13 straight Sweet 16s.
Yeah.
Ran into Boston College with a team that was had won the national championship. There's another one of those back cuts.
Yep. Smith this time from Akita McClain.
And it eliminated that incredible run by Dean Smith to get into the Sweet 16. A team that a lot of people projected would win the national championship 2 years in a row, but they didn't get it done.
Well, Hansborough as well. That team eventually lost to Florida in the regional finals. Lon Kruger's team made it to the Final Four. That was the Billy Curley team.
Right.
Boston College had back in 94. Greg Smith got the foul, his second. Those were some tough regional finals that particular year in the NCAA. Roy Williams a little hot. Felt like there's a little too much contact on the other end of the floor. He's letting Gary Maxwell know about it. Up at the top of your screen.
Green waited a little too long to get that ball to Hansborough.
Thomas finds Green. Not there.
There was Hansborough. Oh,
strength of Hansborough. Wow. Yes, and a foul. I'm stronger. I'm better. I'm going to show you.
Wow, when he puts two hands on the ball, it is amazing. He just rips that out of there. And Jared Dudley is about as tough and strong a player as you'll find in college basketball. He just rips it away from him.
Yeah, we're talking about a junior that is not necessarily in his first rodeo. And he just ripped it right away from him. Smith got the foul, his third. That's a double whammy. Another three-point opportunity for Hansborough and a third foul on Craig Smith.
You talked about his free throw shooting. Young man was 14 for 14 from the line against North Carolina State. So when he goes to that line, he has been all money here of late.
Marshall on the wing. Not this time. Long rebound to Dudley. He's got some strength too, and he's fouled on the putback. Timeout. BC by 7.
Fundamentals. Watch right here. He got sloppy. Here, right here. That's where he loses it. Let's look at that again.
Hey, honey, did you
always switch it to the other hand, away from where the pursuit is coming?
What exactly are you doing?
That's a mental breakdown. He got a little reckless there, and I'm sure he's going to catch an earful on the sidelines.
Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
天气预报，今天和星期三将会持续低湿度和晴朗。
只要消费者。
Houston needs them one day closer to you.
Houston needs them closer to you.
Well, honey, you.
Billy Packer alongside Tim Brando. We're seeing some guys getting it done in the paint.
Well, there was a case that North Carolina was in the zone defense, Hansbrough, however, allowed Dudley to get low post position. There's Dudley scoring his second field goal in this second half. He only had two at halftime. And there was an excellent feed down inside. Good unselfish play by Noel to Hansbrough. And there are those incredibly strong hands and put back. The freshman doing the job again.
Yes, he is. 7 of 10 from the floor.
The thing about him, you can stop him for a period of time. He didn't score the last 8 minutes of the first half. But when he gets around the basketball, good things are going to happen, either on offensive putbacks, or when he locks up on the low block, forget about it.
Dudley, who missed two free throws in the first half, misses his third.
And really one of the keys for Boston College to win a lot of games. And were it not for poor free throw shooting, they would only have one loss this year. They've not converted at the stripe the way they have in the past. These are players, Dudley, Smith, Marshall, all of them. They love to get to the line, but they have to convert once they get there.
In the Maryland game that they lost, they were 5 for 15 yep. from the line in their first ACC game of the year.
That was back in December.
Straight man to man now, there's the double down.
Hansbrough lost it to Dudley. Tries to save it.
Is anybody out of bounds?
Yes,
in the case is.
Yeah.
Hansbrough's out of bounds while he's touching the ball. Referee right on top of it.
Hansbrough has 8 of North Carolina's 11 points in this half.
Now what he's got to recognize there is that the double team is coming quickly now. As soon as he touches the ball, he's going to have to pop it right back out, particularly if he can find Miller.
Alley-oop for Craig Smith from Louis Hennett.
Third time in this half that they've been able to go over the top of the North Carolina defense from way out on the perimeter.
Noel lost it. Those kinds of turnovers, Billy, are really creeping up for North Carolina. As I said earlier, not a lot of pressure in the backcourt, but already 14 turnovers. We've still got 15 minutes left. RBC Centura presents this look at our upcoming ACC telecasts, and we'll do that shortly.
Against Southern Cal, this North Carolina team, a loss on the West Coast. 13 assists, 25 turnovers. I don't care how well you're shooting, how well you're rebounding. You're going to turn it over like that, you're in serious trouble. See how Smith stays down on the floor, doesn't walk. Nice passing here.
Shot clock under 5. McLean lets it fly. That's a push. We'll go against Jared Dudley.
Well, it might have been the fact that Miller was so small
right.
that Dudley just overpowered and put him to the floor. And Dudley's saying, I was held. I'm not so sure he wasn't.
There are the upcoming broadcasts we have coming your way, courtesy RBC Centura, including Virginia Tech at Wake Forest, NC State at Clemson, Miami, Florida State. What are your thoughts on this athletic Florida State team that has wreaked havoc against some? They got a big win against Wake.
Yep, they've been in a lot of ball games going down the wire. They are athletic. Thornton, one of the best players in the league. Wake Forest is another story. Really having problems, even at home.
Unable to get it going without Chris Paul, without that prolific point guard that they were accustomed to having. Foul spotted against Boston College. It goes against Akita McLean. You see the points in the paint. BC winning that because they have so many guys that can get the points down there. Tyler Hansbrough is a one-man wrecking crew for North Carolina.
It's a very important couple of minutes here for North Carolina. Are they going to make another run at them here on their home floor? Or with Hansbrough sitting down, is Boston College going to continue to improve on this lead?
Well, we haven't heard from Wes Miller, Billy. He got an early three. He's been stifled since.
Not a good shot.
Noel tries to save it and does. That's a bump. Good call by Gary Maxwell as Sean Williams goes over and really bailed him out by bumping. That's 3 on him.
Yeah, Williams has really not gotten into Boston College basketball this year yet. As you know, he sat out the first semester and really hasn't picked up where he left off last year, which many people thought, myself included, that he could become one of the Big East top players this year, but it hasn't happened. Having to sit out that first semester.
And certainly had a presence that was felt by many in the league before he came over to the Atlantic Coast Conference. This broadcast is a copyrighted presentation. Any use of it
without the express permission of Raycom, Jefferson Pilot Sports, and the ACC is prohibited. David Noel at the free throw line. A well-documented off-the-court incident for Williams. It cost him some playing time, and it affects the chemistry of the club. They're only now really beginning to get accustomed to having him out there on the deck.
Now, who hasn't been in the ball game in this second half is Rice, who's the guy that made it all happen in the first half with 11 points. If North Carolina's going to pressure full court, expect Al Skinner to get him in here.
Al Skinner is very protective of freshmen. It's his belief that they have a tougher time rebounding from mistakes than veteran players. So the leash is always relatively short for Tyrese Rice. But he did hit the game winner against Miami. One would think that Al will certainly give him some more playing time here in the second half at some point. Wes Miller leaves. Bobby Fraser back on the floor for North Carolina. Keita McClain.
Oh, that's a bad foul. Bad foul by Frazier. He had just come into the ball game.
Veteran move, too, by Lil Jenner. He felt in the sort of a quasi-Reggie Miller move there to induce the foul.
Well, there were 10 seconds left on the shot clock when this happened. There's no reason for Frazier to foul it.
Yeah, he knew it once he got up under, and then Hinnett, understanding where Frazier was, just threw his body into Frazier's to pick up the foul. It's a good call.
Smart play by Hinnett.
Yes, it was.
This young guy has got it better than a 2-to-1 assist turnover ratio, which is what you need in the backcourt. Kind of guy that can lead, not throw the ball away. Coming into the season, 334 assists, 163 turnovers. So he has been solid throughout his career.
I think one of the question marks for many that followed Boston College, particularly in Beantown, would be the speed of the game in the ACC, particularly the reputation in the backcourts. How would Lewis Hinnett handle it? To this point, he's done very well. Ginyard using his body, wave it off.
Wow. I didn't like that call at all, and I'll tell you why. There was no defense in any position. Ginyard was just going up and taking a basic shot. It's a big call there.
Yeah, it is. Jared Dudley claps like the veteran, saying, I've earned it. There's the 15th turnover.
The Academy Award himself a foul on that play. It was Tom Davis. Tom Davis bounce passing by Boston College.
Yep.
Doing it extremely well.
Here's a Lewis Hinnett coming back for the ball that time. Saved the steal by Fraser. Sean Williams with the shot clock winding down. Not this time. Dudley again. Rejected by Terry. Fraser has Terry with him. A pull-up.
A tough shot.
Yep. That in-between game. Got a break situation. Tough to pull off.
Yeah, when you pull up at that short a distance, you either take it all the way to the hole and go for the dunk with his ability, or give that ball up. It's a very difficult shot.
Marshall draws nothing but air, but there's McClain. Unable to convert. Terry clears for North Carolina.
Now, with Smith out of the ball game right now, Boston College all of a sudden has changed the way they're operating. And there's Williams with another cheap foul inside.
That's four on Sean Williams. Remember, Oates has got three as well. He's sitting along with Smith. One of the bodies they can use on Hansbrough.
Smith, we see on the sideline, we see Roy Williams slam his coat to the floor. The foul had been called. So he got that call, but that coat went to the floor. He's playing in shirt sleeves right now.
Giving Rayshon Terry a little bit of his mind right now.
I think it's about that shot that we just saw coming down on the break. Take it strong to the hole and go for the dunk and draw the foul. Roy Williams didn't want to see a guy pull up and take a very low percentage shot on the break like that. That was short all the way.
It's also good to have a player to get in to get on his case when you're also maybe a little upset with officiating. Good timing by the outstanding coach.
See how Boston College sits down with that interior passing. Nice job.
And Tyrese Rice on the floor with Hinnett. Hinnett knows he's pointing to Rice saying, my fault, I shouldn't have thrown that one to you. I forced it.
got away with it, though, out of bounds off North Carolina.
Hansbrough has been sitting down for a while, now going to sit down again. Sanders done a pretty good job in this ball game. Touch foul on Noel.
That's three on David Noel. Noel's got one of those bodies that they really need on the floor. His defense in the closing seconds of Thornton, that last sequence for Florida State, really crucial. Rice can't hit. Marshall out-fought Hinyard for that one.
Solid game by Marshall today. Offensively, getting tough rebounds, setting some good screens inside. There's that back screening down inside on the baseline by Boston College. It's worked really well for him. Again.
Oh, McLean backdoor from Craig Smith. Wow.
And I realize Smith has piled up some big numbers with scoring and rebounding of late. But what I really like about him tonight is his delivery of the ball, his patience with the ball, and getting his teammates involved.
Sanders back on the floor, unable to come up with that one. Saved by Smith.
You never throw the ball back in under the other team's basket. Boston College gets away with it.
Rice in the open floor. Did not make up his mind. He was looking for Marshall, then got into no man's land. We're going to have an overrule. No, perhaps not. North Carolina will have it when we come back. In the front or in the back door, it can happen. BC with the lead.
In sports, if you want to know where you're going,
LeBron,
you've got to know where you've been.
Jordan, look at that!
On Classic Now, we tie the past to the present.
From Unitas to Marino to Manning, Wilt to Kareem to Shaq, Koufax to Clemens to, well, Clemens. Every weeknight, host Josh Elliott brings you the sports news like you've never seen it before. Classic Now, where the past is always present. Weeknights at 7 and 11, only on ESPN Classic.
If you don't have ESPN Classic, get Classic Now.
Scott?
Mm-hmm.
Did you possibly switch chairs with me?
No. No, not me.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Good luck finding your chair, LeBron.
Okay. Okay.
Own the best DVDs from ESPN Home Entertainment.
I'm all in.
The compelling dramas.
Bannister, you'll never forgive yourself if someone else gets there first.
The hard-hitting stories.
The Olympics will go on.
The memorable games. From fans.
Let's rock and roll.
For fans.
You got to know the fundamentals.
Ain't nobody better than me.
Own these amazing DVDs. Available in stores and at ESPNShop.com. From ESPN Home Entertainment.
55-43, Boston College with the lead. We were talking about this topsy-turvy thing called college basketball. Consider going into this season. We had schools that had consecutive streaks of being in the AP Top 25 poll. This was all preseason, Billy. Well, Kansas gone, Kentucky gone, Arizona gone, North Carolina gone, Oklahoma State gone. And now Duke and UConn remain. It just tells you something about how fleeting momentum can be, no matter what the size of the school or the reputation of its past.
Well, you look at this man right here who obviously led his team to a national championship last year and then loses seven players off of that squad. Very difficult to retool and be
it's
a
never happened.
25 team, right?
It's never happened in the history of the sport. There you see the story from the floor by the halves. Boston College with so many shots at the basket though. That's impressive. Hansbrough is fouled by McLean.
Showing all kinds of moves inside. That time, great drop step move down to the baseline. No one from Boston College has seen that move tonight. Terrific job. You talk about things that haven't happened. Well, I'll tell you one thing that has happened. Boston College started 0-3, right?
Yeah.
In 97, so did North Carolina. You know what they did from that point on? They won 16 straight. They, in effect, won the ACC tournament and went to the Final Four, losing to the team that they'll have coming here Saturday, Arizona.
That's right.
So can Boston College emulate that? So far, they have not lost a game since they started 0-3 in the conference.
Nice save by Hansbrough. Leading Lewis in it to the ball and then deflecting it off of him. Wes Miller will trigger it in. Rayshon Terry, Marcus Guignard, Danny Green, and Tyler Hansbrough, the five on the floor for Roy Williams.
Out of bounds defense. Terrific job by Green. This is the way he started the ball game. I really like the way BC plays an out of bounds defense. Okay, everybody sees the passer. They drop back in a tight zone.
Now this one time Berries and Cream crowd, that was the reputation here at Chapel Hill. They are being heard from right now.
There's a steal by Green. Hansbrough running the floor with him. Look out below. Count it and a foul.
That is exactly why Roy Williams was on Terry's case before. He wanted Terry to take that ball right to the basket and score instead of pulling up with a short jumper. Hansbrough does just that. Third time tonight, the young man has scored on the break. Take it right to the hoop or give it up. And that was against Marshall, veteran ball player.
Shaunt Marshall, his second, yet another three-point opportunity. His 24th of the season. And he has been money at the stripe all year. The lead whittled down to five. Listen to this crowd at the Dean Smith Center.
Here's the guy I'd worry about right now if I'm North Carolina Rice. He is very explosive. Cheap foul.
Wes Miller didn't like it. He's pretty tough on the ball.
Well, what you got to understand as a player is how the game is being officiated.
Right.
And what these guys have been doing is on touch fouls out on the perimeter, they've been calling inside, bang, and they haven't. So you got to know where you can maybe put a little body on and where you can't. Here's Rice.
You like this matchup against Guignard, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I think he can take him. I'm surprised he gave up the ball.
Wayne, nice pass to Smith. Boy, they had a triangle working there.
Just a great job by Boston College. Very unselfish.
And that's the way Al Skinner likes to see it. That's a walk by Terry. Roy Williams believes the pivot foot never went up.
Well, how about this interior passing? Just a good job. And there's North Carolina again. Turnovers, mental turnovers, really cost them. You make a nice run physically, take it away with a bad run mentally.
Rice lobbing it, a little too strong for Smith. Hansbrough clears. Williams wants Miller to take it all the way in, as close to the lid as he can get. BC's transition defense, though, has been pretty good. Miller.
Wow, that was a long, long shot. Is that that two-handed rebound again?
Amazing. Absolutely off the charts. And the foul spotted inside.
That was in traffic.
Well, during the first half, Billy, we asked the Zaltel Text to win an ACC Trivia Challenge. Boston College played what ACC team in their first tournament game back in 58? You knew it. You had to keep quiet. Only one got in back then, so you had to know, right? Maryland and the Terps beat the Eagles. Tune in to our next telecast for your chance to play Text to Win ACC Trivia Challenge presented by Altel.
That's that Bud Milliken team that North Carolina won the national championship in 57. Maryland came back and knocked Carolina out.
Bud
58 Milliken. ACC yeah. tournament.
Bud Milliken went on to coach Gary Williams into the 60s before leaving. That
yeah, nice little connection with Gary Williams and BC head coach.
That's right.
Now at Maryland.
In fact, you hear the crowd responding to Tyler Hansbrough. Maryland's win tonight for Gary Williams tied him with Lefty Frizzell for all-time winningest coach at College Park. There you see that run, 9-2 for North Carolina. Dudley left free up top.
Huge shot.
He's a tough player. He is a quality complimentary player. I mean, he loves being the second option.
Terry, nice left-handed maneuver in the lane.
Well, maybe that left shirt by Roy Williams did some good. Terry took that one hard to the basket.
Rice is on the floor, along with Sean Williams, Smith, Dudley, and Hennett. So three bigs in effect in the game for Boston College. Reach-in foul against Danny Green.
And look again, if you're looking at a teaching technique, all of these Boston College guys, whether it's in the low post or the high post, when they catch the ball, they sit down. Right. Makes it very difficult for the guy that's going to reach in because they sit down, few hands on the ball, and as a defender, you're not used to being down in that strong a position. Boston College passes extremely well out of that.
You know, in a lot of ways, Billy, I've had the occasion to meet and talk with Al Skinner through the years since he became a head coach. The only time he ever coached, by the way, in this building, 1988 as an assistant to Tom Penders at Rhode Island. I believe you were here for that. That was the Carlton Owens, Tom Garrett teams, and they played wonderfully. But he is an under-the-radar coach. I think he likes the fact that his team is maybe overlooked nationally as one of the premium clubs. They were when they were in the Big East. And after that 0-3 start, they sort of have been in the ACC early on this season.
Absolutely.
Sanders in traffic. Now has his pocket picked by Dudley. Return to sender, North Carolina.
Should have numbers here.
Knocks it away. There's Ginyard. Over Smith, too strong. The follow by Green.
Freshman to freshman. Green was waiting out on the perimeter potentially on that semi-break for his jump shot. So a good job to follow up.
Dudley, tough again. From Smith, wave it off. They're going to call an offensive foul. Player control, third against Dudley.
Again, notice how Boston College sitting down to make that entrance pass and catching the ball sitting down.
They are rocking at the Dean Dome. We'll be back.
ABC News Now. Finally, something designed for your hectic life. Imagine programs 15 minutes long and tightly packed with all the good stuff you actually want. Hit the ground running with ABC News Now.
ABC News Now.
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 ABC News Now.
Get it now.
Now.
ABC News.
Anytime, anywhere.
Get it now.
Now imagine being able to get it all. Anytime and anywhere. Hey, that's why you need ABC News Now.
Thanks for filling in, Mr. Urlacher.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Happy to help.
Join us in March for ESPN The Weekend at the Walt Disney World Resort. There's something for every fan. Visit ESPNTheWeekend.com today. Presented by SpeedStick 24/7.
Oh. You all right?
Yeah. It's an old football injury. Tore my rotator cuff against the Giants in 88. Yeah. Got to play hurt, though, right?
Oh, absolutely. Actually, I burnt my tongue on some lentil soup last night. It really hurts.
Be okay to do the show?
Oh, yeah. I'll suck it up.
What makes them different makes them great. Mike and Mike in the Morning on ESPN Radio.
Well, this thing is just about over now. They'll snap the ball, take a knee, and that'll end it. Bills are going to drop this one, and wait a second. The ball is loose. Fisher got it, and he's got Walker to the 20. He's to the 10. Touchdown, Bills! Holy moly! What? No! They're gonna say he stepped out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The game comes to an end. The Bills lose a heartbreaker.
A full weekend of ACC basketball coming up Saturday, 3 o'clock. Virginia Tech travels to Winston-Salem. Both teams hungry. Wake Forest and Virginia Tech. Then Sunday, a double dose. NC State to Clemson, followed by Miami and Florida. ACC basketball on Rakeworth Jefferson Pilot Sports. Take a look at our Jeep game summary. Turnovers, again, the Achilles of North Carolina, but Hansbrough cleaning up a lot of that mess once the ball gets down into the painted area.
Here's that matchup zone. Angelo wanting that ball inside. Smith doing a good job staying right with him in his area of the zone. And they'll give him the jump shot from there. Again, with this zone, I think we should run your man-to-man offense because it really matches up.
In close, that's an offensive foul. Again, that's player control, Craig Smith, third position.
Third time in this ball game that he's drawn the charge inside.
Three fouls on Rayshon Terry. We should mention Sean Williams also on the floor for Boston College, number 51 playing with four fouls.
To put in perspective this ball club that Boston College has, they were 25-5 last year, started 20-0, and four of their starters are back.
That's right.
So this is not like this is some club that's coming out of nowhere.
No, much more so than either Miami or Virginia Tech a year ago.
Absolutely.
They came in with championship pedigree.
Nice.
Smith to Williams.
He recognized the double team. He is really having an outstanding game, although his numbers are not what they have been in recent games as far as scoring and rebounding. Just good decision making.
Good assist. There's the answer from Terry downtown. Rayshon with nine.
After that little talking to by Roy Williams, Terry has done the job.
North Carolina getting extreme effort from Tyler Hansbrough and those spurts that keep him in it. But this has been exemplary play by the road team.
As Dudley connects, he's got 13. Terry.
Lane's time to take that shot, but a great rebound.
Ginyard gets to it. His first field goal of the night.
Considering the score, that was probably not a wise decision by Terry to take that jump shot. Hansbrough was not anywhere near being under the basket for a rebound.
And Ginyard was there to clean it up.
Hansbrough fighting Smith for position down and low. Too late.
Yeah, it's. Oh, there's a rejection by Terry from the backside, and Williams just got his fifth.
I'll tell you, one of the things that could help North Carolina right here, we have seen Boston College playing a lot of minutes. Now, normally, this man right here, Smith and Dudley, do play the minutes, but they've had to go a long time out here, and North Carolina's played a deeper squad tonight at a higher pace game. And a good call by Al Skinner. He wants a timeout right now to rest his guys a little bit. I think he's going to take it after he puts a man in. I thought he's going to take get a little bit more extended time, but he doesn't do it.
Well, he's also using the opportunity to talk to the officials.
I'll tell you, really good bench decorum on his part, though. He's a class act.
Talk about outstanding players. He spent 4 years in the professional ranks, actually played in the ABA. And a wonderful career at UMass.
You know, it's kind of interesting, the ACC connection with Boston College without a coaching. You got Daly, who started off at Duke as an assistant, was up there. Tom Davis, who was an assistant at Maryland, that eventually ended up as a head coach there. And, of course, Gary Williams, who we mentioned before. All three guys have an outstanding success there.
Al is going after his 300th career coaching victory tonight, encompassing his years at Rhode Island before Boston College.
Now this is as close as North Carolina has been in a long, long time.
Down two. 5.5 remaining. Tim Brando, Billy Packer, happy to have you with us.
Smith in there, unstoppable.
We've got three freshmen on the floor playing against a very experienced team right now.
Into double digits, 12 points for him. Ginyard. Smith rips down the rebound.
And protects it.
Yep. You see the points in the paint, and that's coming from really a committee for BC. Marshall's had his, as has Akita McClain and Craig Smith. Dudley as well.
With 4 minutes to go, I think North Carolina has to get Hansbrough back in the ballgame, whether he's tired or not.
And Byron Sanders getting a lot of playing time. And this is a tough matchup for him. Rice. Oh, the smooth lefty. He is something else. 14 points for him. And he gets his with little playing time.
And what he also does, he takes away the press because he's so quick with that dribble. Hansbrough is coming back in the ballgame right now. Miller as well. And Terry. Be a bad idea idea to take a timeout here to get them back in the ball game.
A little flying Walinda from Danny Green.
Well, he started out in this ball game looking smooth from the outside. That was quite a play.
Yeah.
That was a big possession. Roy Williams trying to get three starters back in the ball game and get saved by Green.
15 points for Danny Green. And clearly a little carryover from his hot shooting in Tallahassee over the weekend. Smith sets the pick, trying to release Rice. He'll take it anyway.
Can you believe that young guy?
He's got such a quick release.
It's amazing that he's had the ball in his hands more than Hinnett has going down the wire here.
You're right. 5-point deficit for North Carolina. Tough pass. What a look by Hinnett inside to Rice. And you see that and you can understand why Al Skinner is going with both of his point guards in this lineup.
Well, and particularly coming down the wire here, this is not a team that you can press very easily.
Little run out by Smith. Leaves an opening for Guignard. Smith came away from the basket and BC paid a price.
Probably not a good idea by Smith to go out there and press that far away from the basket, because Frazier's not going to take that shot anyway.
They are standing at the Dean Smith Center, their home team trailing by five. 2:40 and counting. Dudley working on Green. Smith far from the basket, but he likes the matchup. And he takes advantage of Sanders.
And they haven't been able to get Hasbro back into the ball game.
Well, you mentioned
the timeout was appropriate to get those guys back on the floor.
Green off the back iron. Guignard struggles to save it and does. They've been trying to get there for well over 2 minutes. Foul will go against Nikita McLean. And at long last, Hansbro will get off the seat of his pants.
Right, there he went from about 4:08 down to 2:08, trying to get the key players into the ball game. That's a very valuable 2 minutes.
Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
America's top critics have fallen in love with the biggest surprise of the holidays.
Very impressive.
Casanova is romantic, sexy, and funny. Funny, funny.
Casanova!
It's the most original comedy since Shakespeare in Love. USA Today calls it a surprise hit. It's a big thumbs up.
I'm in love with you, Francesca.
For one of the year's best films.
The gift.
The pig cannot come in, but the animal will take.
Casanova, rated R, now playing.
You're here to play basketball my way, and my way is hard.
We did not back down ever!
From producer Jerry Bruckheimer.
You're gonna put the whole program at risk.
I gave those kids my word.
You wanna shut them up, then win.
If there was ever more of a mismatch, I don't remember it.
It's not about talent, it's about heart.
You're 24 hours from the biggest game in college basketball.
You gotta take it!
Glory Road. Rated PG, directed by James Gardner.
Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
Take a look, Billy, at Boston College's work inside.
Well, there's Smith inside doing a great job with Sanders on him. North Carolina could not get Hasbro into the ball game. 2 minutes elapsed right there, and very important 2 minutes to have a key player on the floor. There's this great baseline cutting by Boston College. Any number of players have been able to do that extremely well.
There's a look at our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game, leading scorers, and Craig Smith, his numbers are outstanding, but tonight, Billy, The intangibles, the things outside the box score have been impressive. And, of course, Hansbrough keeps on keeping on for North Carolina.
What I like about any outstanding player is a player that can let the game come to him instead of trying to make it, particularly when your team is playing extremely well. He did that. In the first half, he had 2 points. He was 1 for 5. Now he's looking at a night where he's 7 for 12. He's made 7 of 8 field goals. In the second half, he's got 14 points. Great leadership on his part.
See, a full complement of timeouts in our reset for both teams. Maybe more than necessary with just 2:08 remaining. Danny Green checks out. Rayshon Terry will come in. A lot of offensive and defensive substitutions being made down the stretch here.
North Carolina with their original starting lineup. Rice, the only change that Boston College has from its original lineup. Tough to press this guy.
Not the double team, and quickly a timeout called. The bench really got involved with that one. The assistants, Bill Cohen and Ed Cooley, Pat Duquette, all urging Tyrese Rice to get the timeout.
Well, a good call on his part. Not want to give away that possession.
Ready to elevate your golf game to the next level? Learn from the professionals at ESPN Golf Schools presented by Lexus. Enroll in the 3-Club Tour and receive a Nike Sasquatch driver, SVU wedge, and T100 putter free. ESPN Golf Schools instruction developed by world-renowned teaching pro Hank Haney. Call 1-800-642-5528 or register online at ESPNGolfSchools.com. Improve your game through personalized instruction and the latest in equipment from Nike Golf. ESPN Golf Schools presented by Lexus.
Guys, if you're not nervous, you're not alive. Get an opportunity like this, you gotta be. I'm gonna leave it all right here.
They're not getting screened. Don't get screened.
Go, Benny, go. What are you doing here?
It ought to hurt to get an opportunity like that, and we didn't get it done.
Sunday, February 5th on ABC.
Burglary, assault, homicide.
Killing of unborn child.
Friday on an all-new Injustice.
I believe I helped put away an innocent man.
There's only one team that can right something so wrong.
You can free an innocent man.
What made you change your mind?
You fight for what you believe in.
Your ex-wife ID'd the wrong man.
That's what's going to nail you.
An all-new Injustice, Friday, 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
Tim Brando, Billy Packer here in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Boston College leading by 6 at an 8-point lead, 12-point lead at the break. This is the second time North Carolina's faced a huge deficit in games at halftime. One on the road and now here at home. Marshall on the floor with Smith. Again, Tyrese Rice at the point with Dudley and Hennepin. Shot clock under 10. There's the dump down to Smith. Over Hansbrough. Would have counted had it gone. He'll get to the stripe for 2.
He is a load inside, isn't he? He's got that wide body, good hands. He's got that little half hook. Has drop step moves. He's tough to handle in there.
You know, the other thing, too, you overlook it because he's got so many outstanding half court aspects to his game, but his hands get in there a lot. A lot of deflections. He had 22 steals. And for a big man, that's not bad. He and Dudley both were outstanding at turning the ball over for their team's defenses collectively coming in.
No 68% free throw shooter, and on the floor right now, he and Marshall are the two weakest free throw shooters on this squad. That's presently on the floor.
Rattles that one home. 75-68, 15 on the night for the preseason All-American.
Dangerous pass.
Ansbrough on the bounce, right to the cup, doesn't finish.
You know, he expected contact, and it wasn't there, Jim.
Yep.
And he didn't realize till the last second he was wide open and came up short on the shot. Watch this. He expects contact here. There's nobody there, and he, oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Smith came over late.
Exactly.
And he picks up his fourth foul.
Maybe that's the best way to handle him. Just don't give him contact.
And the end result, it looked like a nonchalant finger roll move, which you're right. I think between the ears, he felt, wait a minute, where's the bump? I've got to be getting some contact here.
Smith back at the line.
And really the key to this ball game has been the ball handling and that number one assist turnover ratio. There's a not good looking soft shot by Smith.
Yeah, he's talking to himself now.
DC on the game, 22 assists, 9 turnovers.
Yeah.
Well, that's number one in the ACC, and they continue again tonight. North Carolina, 16 assists, 19 turnovers. That's the story of this ballgame.
The free throw issue for BC continues. Just over 50%, got that one to go. They're 8 of 14 as a team.
Well, I think inside out here and looking for Miller or Terry for jump shots, but the ball's got to get inside first.
Now, Hennett is caught fronting hands throw with Smith behind him. Miller, a rainbow.
Wes Miller gets it with a timeout. They're down 5 with 1:06 remaining. Well, the James Madison transfer getting it done. We'll return after this message from Boston College.
Burglary, assault, homicide.
Killing of unborn child.
Friday on an all-new Injustice.
I believe I helped put away an innocent man.
There's only one team that can right something so wrong.
And free an innocent man.
What made you change your mind?
You fight for what you believe in.
Your ex-wife's ID'd the wrong man.
And that's what's gonna nail you.
An all-new Injustice, Friday 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
76-71, DC trying to hold on and get a really meaningful conference victory. And you could tell at today's shoot-around, these guys were, this is a pretty nice place. They had never played in this building, and they have had tremendous poise throughout much of this game. Falling behind early, then a huge 26-6 run to close out the first half, and they've not surrendered the lead in the second.
Rice tough to press man-to-man. They got to come out and get him. Two-possession game at this point.
Oh, what a pass.
North Carolina extended the defense, and Tyrese Rice made him pay.
They need a very quick hoop.
Take another timeout.
Yeah, they really are. Miller for 3 off the bounce. Off the front iron, and Rice has it.
And
good judgment.
Yes, he did exercise good judgment.
Yep. Clock is your teammate here. Rice, instead of taking it down, trying to do something spectacular, pulls that ball back out. Young man has done a nice job teaming up with Hennett in the backcourt going down the stretch here.
We're talking about Rice. How about Red Lobster presenting the nothing but net shot of the game? This was big, Billy, because it extended the lead to 70-63. Right when North Carolina was making a big run.
Well, I think as BC keeps their movement, and we talked about North Carolina starting 0-3 one year and going on to win the ACC tournament, this Boston College team now looks like the team that was picked preseason to be number 2 behind Duke. This is a good ball club.
Frazier with time winding down feeds Hansbrough for 3. And gets it to roll through. 79-74, 17.9 remaining. And Tyler showing his dexterity by coming beyond the arc. We'll return after this message from the University of North Carolina.
That's his first 3.
Burglary, assault, homicide.
Killing of unborn child.
Friday on an all-new Injustice.
I believe I helped put away an innocent man.
There's only one team that can right something so wrong.
And free an innocent man.
What made you change your mind?
You fight for what you believe in.
Your ex-wife's ID'd the wrong man.
That's what's gonna nail you.
An all-new Injustice, Friday 9, 8 Central, only on ABC.
79-74, and Tyler Hansbrough has had quite an evening, 26 points.
But really, the committee of Boston College in the paint and also the use of the backcourt, Hennett as well as Tyrese Rice, a real key, a career high for Hasbro. But it could be in defeat.
Go for the foul right here. Yep. Waited too long.
And they wind up fouling Dudley rather than Smith. Now, Jared Dudley only a little better at the line than Smith on the year, 70%.
Well, the key there was the foul, the first man to touch the ball inbounds. Each second is so important at this stage when you've got a two-possession game.
Our Pepsi players of the game, not surprisingly, the two guys in the middle, Greg Smith and Tyler Hansbro.
You know, for Hansbro, you've got to think of who he has played well against.
Oh.
Collins from Virginia Tech,
right,
dominated him in that game. He did a good job also against NC State, against the superior big man.
Oh, Simmons.
And now tonight, he does a nice job with Smith and other people guarding him.
Yeah, so, Cedric Simmons gave Craig Smith a hard time.
Absolutely. Take it to the basket.
Frazier deflected by Smith, gathered in by Dudley, and a quick foul.
Frazier pulled away from the basket. He'd been smart to take that one right at the basket and try to get fouled.
Tyler Hansbrough picks up his fifth.
And frankly, that's what you sense from Roy Williams most of the time talking to his younger players. He's saying, take it to the rack. Take it straight to the goal as quickly as you can.
Well, here's the thing, Tim. Not to necessarily shoot the shot. You're down six. It's a two-possession game if you shoot threes, but not if you take twos. So, at that case, a penetration by a guard for a kickout. But he's just a freshman. He'll have to think of those things.
Well, we mentioned Boston College, an 0-3 start. They've responded now with three straight wins and a couple of those on the road. That'll make you feel awfully good about your game. The question marks now beginning to come into the minds of a lot of teams as conference play prolongs, and Boston College is getting some answers to their questions. Frazier rejected again. And that'll do it. Boston College comes away with a very big road victory, 81-74. BC moving to 15-4 overall, 3-3 in the ACC. North Carolina drops to 11-5 and 3-3 in conference play. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
With 21, including 11 in overtime. Bulls beat the Raptors 104-88. Cavaliers, a 9-point win in Atlanta, 106-97 for their third consecutive victory, 38 for LeBron James. Wizards get a couple of free throws from Gilbert Arenas with 2 seconds to go and beat Boston 89-87. Spurs, an 84-68 win over the Hornets. Golden State at home, a 24-15 first quarter lead on Dallas. Portland leading Denver 56-46, minute to go in the first half. College basketball, some surprises as number 4 Florida falls on the road at South Carolina. Back-to-back losses for the Gators after 17 wins to start the season. Gamecocks win at 68-16.
Coming off a win in Tallahassee, our next game, Virginia Tech and Wake Forest, on many of these Raycom and Jefferson Pilot sports stations. Now for Billy Packer, our producer Rob Reichle, and director Mike Miller, Tim Brando, saying so long from Chapel Hill, North Carolina, where tonight BC got a huge road victory. Their first at the Dean Dome since joining the ACC. For all of us, good night, everybody, from Chapel Hill.
Louisville, they beat Cincinnati 67-50. Maryland wins at Georgia Tech by a dozen. George Washington, a 94-78.
Famous.
Oh God, I love him so much. I know if I could just get backstage, if I could just meet him, if he had a chance to get to know the real me, then we'd fall in love and he'd marry me and he'd take me to his castle in England.
XM 46, Top Tracks.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? What